Hey guys, what's up? As promised, a post Shadow of Mordor commentary. I'm going to tell you what I thought about the game and having played it now. As you know, I finished it and just what my general thoughts were. So first off, I think the silent approach was good for this game. I wouldn't use a silent approach universally. I wouldn't apply it to every game I play. But because Mordor, as you could tell, is pretty much a pure action game with some somewhat minimally integrated RPG elements, I think the silent approach was just fine. But there you have it, folks. I mean, what is Shadow of Mordor and Middle-earth Shadow of Mordor? It's a really good action game. It's tons of fun. I don't think it has a lot of replay value, but it's just a really fun game if you like that kind of thing, and I do sometimes. I mean, I'm primarily an RPG guy, but I do have my moments. I'm fanatically interested in Ghost Recons as well, and that's an online shooter, PvP shooter. So, Stardust has some variation sometimes, and in this case, yeah, this was just a fun, super fun game. The combos, the execution moves, really, really well done. One thing the game did really well as well, I think, is that it gave you a feeling of just being really powerful. You're imbued with this revenant, effectively. You are an agent of vengeance, this revenant going around taking revenge on Sauron and his armies and his accomplices. And that's it, certainly it fulfills on that. It fulfills that. It delivers on that promise that here you are, this formerly mortal ranger, and now you're a revenant come back from the dead, and they're there to wreak vengeance, and that's done really well. I mean, action-wise, I have almost no complaints. The only thing I would complain about, as you probably could have noticed, is the combat was just too bloody easy. There was nothing really challenging about it after a while. The more powerful you got, there wasn't any sort of, how should I say, AI adjustment. It just, you were powerful, then you had that teleportation execution move, Shadow Strike, and it just, yeah, I mean, you're a revenant, I get it. You're a super powerful revenant from the second age, but there are limits. But that said, very, very fun game. They will be periodically releasing DLC. I think the Bright Lord, I'll probably just play that and display that as well, just for fun. Because I did buy the, what do you call it, the season pass thing. So every now and then, I guess they'll be releasing stuff. Could be interesting. But yeah, fun game. What can I say? Beyond that, it's not an RPG by any means. The story elements were pretty minimalistic. I think the art was well done. The graphics, I mean, I really appreciated that aspect. Now, of course. There are several grave lore violations. I don't really want to go into all of them. In fact, I don't want to talk too much in detail about this. I just wanted to give you a synopsis, sort of a recap. I think you can overlook the lore violations if you just take the game for what it is, which is just a fun fantasy action game. That's what it is. It's a fantasy action game with lots of fun, cool combat moves. And sometimes it's fun to play that stuff. I had a blast playing it. Like I said, not much replay value. I'll play whatever DLC is released, but I don't see myself playing this again and again. Whereas, that's the contrast, of course, to an RPG game where you're getting multiple avenues and multiple paths, and there's a lot of replay. I mean, just as an example, back in the day, Dragon Age Origins, I must have had 12 complete playthroughs, as well as 3 times that of incomplete ones. So, all with different elements, of course, involving modding as well. And I mean, then look at Skyrim. I mean, I haven't played in a while. I'm still waiting for that to get set up. But yeah, I mean, same thing. RPGs, just they go the distance. They're sort of marathon runners. Action games are like sprinters, but sometimes it's good to sprint, So I enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed just the gameplay and the action. I guess it was fun to watch, and I'm not adverse to doing this kind of thing again. Playing an action game, but yeah. So there's my synopsis. Not a whole lot to say because hey, it's just a fun action game. The story elements are just kind of meh, but that's what it was supposed to be. I don't like using rating systems, you know, 9 out of 10, but it's a really good action game. It could be the action game of the year, I'd argue, possibly. I mean, the action was that good. It was that fun. The only criticism, once again, to recap a bit, is, yeah, you're kind of OP. I mean, you can just kind of plow through anything after a certain point. But, oh, the Nemesis system, before I go. Nemesis system was well done. Very interesting. Provides something for the mix. So that was really good and integrated well into the action, overall action. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in a bit. Take care. Bye-bye.